Hello everyone, I am Shivikriti Pai from Sri Vaishnav Vidyapeeth Vishwavidyalaya, Sri Vaishnav Institute of Forensic Science. Today I am discussing about the topic browser forensics. First we start with the introduction. Browser forensics is a critical aspect of digital investigations focusing on retrieving and analyzing data from web browsers to identify suspicious activities or access content. This includes examining browsing history, cookies, cache and download list to trace a suspect's online actions, which can reveal visited websites, access frequency and search terms used. Such evidence is essential in computer forensics, which deals with analyzing digital evidence on computers and storage devices to interpret a suspect activities and intentions. Web browsers are essential tools for various online activities including internet browsing, file downloading, social media and email access when used for illegal purposes. Evidence of such activities is stored in browsers' log files. Investigators can find digital evidence like surfing history, records of website visited, second, bookmarks, saved links to frequently visited pages. Download means files that have been downloaded, cookies, data stored by websites to remember user session, cache, temporary storage of web page elements for faster loading. Now we understand what is browser forensic. Web browsing activity is a key focus in digital forensic investigation as it can leave traces of suspects' online behavior. This includes data like cache, history, cookies and download lists, which can reveal visited websites, access times and search terms. However, since multiple web browsers can be used simultaneously, analyzing log files from just one browser or file is insufficient. Effective investigation requires a comprehensive approach that considers the variety of browsers and files where evidence might be distributed. There are various browser artifacts. Browser artifacts are digital traces of a user's web activity, crucial for forensic analysis. They reveal online behavior and history, helping investigators uncover visited websites, search queries, and downloaded files. This evidence aids in probing crimes like cyberbullying, identity theft, and illegal content distribution. Now we discuss about various artifacts used by browser forensics. Browser forensics can utilize various data types to analyze users' web activity. First is navigation history. Tracks website visited, potentially identifying visits to malicious sites. Second one is autocomplete data. Suggests search terms based on frequent searches, offering deeper insights when combined with navigation history. Third one is extension and add-ons. Mini programs that can leave activity traces, providing evidence of usage. Fourth one is favicons. Icons associated with websites that can inform about users' visits. Fifth one is bookmarks, saved websites that indicate user preference and frequent visits. Some more artifacts. Browser forensics involve analyzing various data types to uncover a user's online activity. This includes cache, store web elements like images and scripts to speed up loading times. Logins, record session data such as open tabs and browsing history which may be deleted after the session ends. Another one is form data. Saves information entered in forms of future autofilling. Next one is downloads. Keeps a list of files downloaded by the user. Next one, browser session. Similar to logins, it tracks active browsing data that might be erased after the session. Last one, thumbnails. Generate previews of frequent visited sites for quicker access and visual navigation. Now I tell you why browser forensic is important. Browser forensic is essential because it allows investigators to extract and analyze digital evidence from web browsers, which can be crucial in understanding a suspect's online behavior. This field of forensics can reveal information such as visited websites, search history, downloads, and login details. It's particularly important for identifying how cyber attacks are conducted, tracing the source of malicious software, and providing evidence in legal cases. With the widespread use of internet, browser forensics helps in piecing together digital activities that could be related to criminal actions. Now we discuss about different evidence we found in browser forensics. Web browsers are a rich source of forensic data, capturing first browsing history, list of visited sites with visitation times. Second one is cache, temporary files offering clues to recent web activities. Cookies, data files revealing user interaction with websites. Downloads, records of file downloaded including times and source. Form data, stored input from online forms useful for investigation leads. Now we discuss about recovery methods of browsing history. There are in total four methods. Recover deleted internet history. Second one is access deleted browsing history with log files. Recover deleted browsing history from Google history using DNS cache to find and view deleted browsing history. So the first one is recover deleted internet history through recover data from browser cookies. Browser forensic can recover history through two methods. Browser cookies, small text files stored by browsers that contain user information and website visit data. Second one is Windows system restore, a feature that can restore recently deleted internet history by reverting the system to a previous state. It's accessed via the start menu under system tools. After restoration, the computer reboots and the browser history should be available. Second one is access deleted data browsing history with log files. Another method is to recover the history using log files. Log files, particularly the index data file on Windows computer, can be used to recover long deleted browsing histories. These files can provide evidence such as surfing history, details like typed URLs, redirects, and visit frequency. Second one is bookmark, user created shortcuts to specific websites. Third one is downloads, files saved in default or users specified locations. Cookies, data containing user information such as usernames and passwords. Fifth one is cache, temporary storage of data from recently visited websites. Now third one is recover deleted browsing history from Google history. Using a Google account to recover browser history is effective if you are signed in during the browsing session. Google history retains all web activity including visited pages and devices used. To access this history, sign into Google history where you can view and manage your web activity by date and time. If needed, you can delete specific items from your history using the setting option. The last one is using DNS cache to find and view deleted browsing history. The domain name system can be used to quickly recover search history or browsing session as long as computer has not been restarted. The DNS cache, which stores internet connection, is effective until a system reboots. To view deleted internet history, one can use the command prompt with the command ipconfig all display DNS without shutting down or restarting the computer, which may still reveal the history. Now we discuss about different web browsers. Web browsers are applications that facilitate access to the internet, translating data from web servers into a viewable format on devices. They work by entering a URL, initiating a request by typing a web address, set DNS lookup, translating the URL to an IP address, sending request, asking the web server for data, receiving a response, getting data back from the server, rendering the page, displaying the content on your device. Popular browsers like Chrome, Firefox, and Edge offer features for bookmarking, password management, tab management, web screenshots, and language translation. These are some popular web browsers including Google, Chrome, Mozilla, Firefox, Apple Safari, and Microsoft Edge. These browsers offer a variety of features to manage and save data. First, we discuss about Mozilla Firefox. Mozilla Firefox is a widely used free and open source web browser available on various platforms, including mobile devices. Forensic artifacts in Firefox can be found in areas such as SQLite database, user preference, encrypted authentication data, form history, cookies, cache, bookmark history, and downloads. Firefox was initially released on November 9, 2004, with its stable released at version 123.0.1 as of March 5, 2024, and is written in multiple program languages including C++, JavaScript, HTML, C, and Rust. Firefox is a versatile web browser with features like the Jaco rendering engine, strong privacy setting, and extensive customization options. It's cross-platform compatible and offers a user-friendly interface with tabbed browsing, spell checking, and a download manager. Security-wise, it provides regular update, phishing, and malware protection, and a private browsing mode that ensures user activity is not saved. In Mozilla Firefox, artifacts are stored in the user's profile path, which include various data types crucial for forensic analysis. Profile path houses profile data and most artifacts. Second one is navigation history and bookmarks, stored in a SQLite database. Bookmarks backup kept in a folder with JSLaunch4 files. Cookies contained in an SQLite database holding user data. Cache includes diverse data types of stored frequently accessed web content. Next are form history, stored in an SQLite database, capturing data entered in forms. Add-ons and extensions, also in SQLite database, detailing installed browser enhancement. Third one is favicons, found in an SQLite database, representing website icons. Fourth one is logins and passwords, stored in JSON and database files containing authentication details. And session data, captured in JSLaunch4 file detailing open tabs and website. Next one is downloads, records in an SQLite database listing files downloading through Firefox. Thumbnails, stored in a folder showing image for new tab page previous. Setting and preference, kept in preface.js file containing user configured browser setting. These artifacts are vital for forensic analysis to understand user behavior and preference. Now we discuss about private browsing mode in Firefox. Private browsing mode in Firefox enables user to browse the internet without saving site visit information, but it does not provide anonymity from website, ISPs, or networks. It operates at the application layer of the OS. Additionally, Firefox offers a do not track feature that can be enabled to request website not to track the user's browsing behavior. Now we discuss about the second web browser, Google Chrome. Google Chrome is a popular web browser known for its speed and security. It offers automatic update every 4 weeks, AI integration for improved user experience, cross-device synchronization, extensive customization options, and robust privacy and safety features are the different features provided by Google Chrome. Google Chrome are widely used browser, stores various data types for forensic analysis, including JSON structure for readable configuration data. Second, downloads, records for downloaded files. Third, bookmarks, saved favorite websites. Fourth one is web data, site interaction and form entries. Fifth one is keyword search terms, user entered search phrases. Sixth one is URL database, history of visited web address. Seventh one is history index, a quick reference for browsing history. Eighth one is session data, information on open tabs and windows, top sites database, frequently visited pages. Next one is media cache, stored media content for quick access. Google Chrome stores user data and artifacts in the profile path with a specific SQLite database. There are different profile paths where Google Chrome stores user data and artifacts in the profile path with special SQLite database for navigation history, download, search history, cookies, and login information. These are located within the user data directory of the Chrome installation on a Windows system. Cache contains temporary web data for quick access. Form history stored in a database includes data entered in web forms. Bookmarks saved in JSON format list user saved web pages. Favicons, databases of websites icon for easy identification. These artifacts are essential for digital forensic analysis and are found within user's local application data directory. Google Chrome records session data including current and previous session and tabs in specific files within the user's local data directory. This data directory is crucial for forensic analysis as it provides insight into the user's recent browsing activity. Add-ons and extensions. In the user's local application, data folders, thumbnails, in SQL database for site previews, crucial for digital forensic analysis of user activity. Chrome's incognito mode. Chrome's incognito mode and Chrome guest browsing allow for private internet use by not saving browsing or download histories and deleted cookies after the session ends. All the data is erased once the session is closed. The another web browser is Microsoft Edge. Microsoft Edge is a versatile cross-platform browser developed by Microsoft, available by default on new Windows device and Xbox consoles. It's built on the Chromium engine for broad compatibility and offers features like syncing across device for an unified browsing experience. Edge is designed for diverse use from work to gaming and is regularly updated with new enhancements. Key features of the redesigned Microsoft Edge include tracking prevention, protect privacy by restricting trackers. Lightweight structure offers a streamlined standard-based browser experience without legacy bloat. Support of inking allows annotations directly on web page with hard handwriting and drawings. Microsoft Edge features a personalized content feed called My Feed, integrated with Cortana for virtual assistants and offers in private mode for private browsing that does not track or save users' data. In Microsoft Edge, user data, bookmarks, cache, cookies, these elements are critical for the browser's functionality and user experience. Microsoft Edge stores browsing history in database called history, login credential in encrypted form in the login database, and allow exporting of screenshot with specific command. Decryption tools are needed to access encrypted password. Next web browser is Internet Explorer. Internet Explorer was a Microsoft web browser launched in 1995. Once dominant but criticized for security issues and outdated standards, discontinued in 2020. Its artifacts were found in cookies, history, registry, downloads, and temporary files. The next web browser is Opera. Opera is a fast, secure web browser with unique features like a free VPN and blocker, ad blocker, and integrated messenger. It's multi-platform, Chromium-based, and privacy-focused, with evidence from users' activity found in downloads, bookmarks, web data, and more. Evidence collection analysis of web browser. Web browser facilitate website access and data transfer. They use cookies to store user data, which is cached for quicker access. Integrated analysis involves choosing a browser based on a speed, ease of use, and compatibility, and may require forensic analysis of multiple browsers' logs for comprehensive insight. User activity analysis examining the various actions a user performs in a web browser, like browsing sites and transferring data, while timeline analysis uses browser history logs to sequence a user's activities, adding and tracing potential criminal action. There are some existing tools that investigator uses during browser forensics. Autopsy. First one is Autopsy. Autopsy is a digital forensic tool for Windows and Linux that supports data carving, timeline analysis, and extraction of web artifacts like history, cookies, and bookmarks from browsers such as Firefox, Chrome, and IE. It's widely used in investigation to analyze computer activity and can also recover photos from memory cards. The second one is Browser History Examiner. Browser History Examiner is a forensic tool that captures and analyzes internet history from major desktop browsers like Chrome, Firefox, and Internet Explorer or Windows, examining data such as website visits, searches, downloads, and cache files. Third one is Net Analysis. Net Analysis is a forensic software for analyzing internet browser activity and recovering deleted browser artifacts on computers and mobile devices, offering improvements over existing tools. Fourth one is Internet Evidence. Internet Evidence Finder. Internet Evidence Finder is a forensic tool designed for recovering internet-related evidence from various digital sources, widely used by professionals in digital forensics, IT security, and corporate investigation. In conclusion, the proposed forensic methodology of web browser on window includes analyzing history, cookies, search keywords, website hosts, and download logs to detect suspicious activity, going beyond the capabilities of tools like autopsy, net analysis, and internet evidence finder. It aims to create a framework for identifying user activities that may be indicative of misconduct based on browser's login. Now we learn how to see the web browsing history by using the Browser History Examiner tool. First, we open the Browser History Examiner tool. Tap on Continue Trial and click OK. Now close this pop-up. Tap on File and click on Capture History option. Now select the option Capture History from this computer. Wait for some time and select the destination folder where you want to save your capture data. Then tap on Capture. Capturing of the browsing history now begins. Now click Yes to save the captured history. Here you can view the complete history report. You can also view the individual artifacts and its history. You can also see the site visited by the user. From this option, you save the summary report of the browsing history. Here you can see the web browsing history report is generated. Thank you.